Hi, and welcome back to Break 100 Golf. I'm John. If you're looking for information about the Garmin Approach R10, the software options, and the cost, then you come to the right place. Let's get right into it. First of all, you can download the application for the Garmin Golf app in the iOS Apple App Store for your iPad or iPhone, or for your Android phone from the Google Play Store. Here's some screenshots of my phone with all of the options that are available with the Garmin Golf app. First off, you have Home Tee Hero. Home Tee Hero, I'll go over the cost at the end here, but Home Tee Hero has 42,000 golf courses. The graphics are more apt for your phone or your iPad, or to maybe screen mirror it or Google Chromecast it to a TV or a monitor where you can see your ball launches. Like if you're gonna hit it into a net or something like that, it's a really good option. And then you also have the driving ranges. Those are free with the Garmin Golf app. And there's four of those. And again, you can use that to stream to a TV or use it with just your phone or iPad. Let's take a look at some of the screenshots. Now, the graphics are going to be a bit cartoony with the Garmin Golf app, but I think that that's totally okay with a phone or an iPad, or if you're going to mirror it to a TV. And that's how I got my first start. I was driving it into a Spornia golf net. I'll put an image of that up on the screen. I was driving it into a Spornia golf net and screen mirroring the image of the Garmin Golf app onto a TV so I could watch my ball launches. But then I graduated to a full golf sim. But this is a great app if you're just getting started, or if you're just gonna take it to the range, the driving range, or if you're gonna use it to drive into a net and screen mirror it to like a TV. So they do have a weekly tournament. Before I get into the software, here's some of the screenshots. Here is from one of the driving ranges. And next, another shot from one of the driving ranges. You can set up different distances to go to. This is in a vertical mode right here. Next, here's some radar metrics and a shot that I took with one of my golf clubs. And this is really interesting here. So here are all of the radar metrics that are available with the Garmin Golf app and your Garmin Approach R10. So you've got club head speed, club face angle, club path angle, angle of attack, ball speed, launch angle, launch direction, spin axis, spin rate, apex height, smash factor, carry distance, total distance, and deviation distance. And what's great is, you know, if you have this launch monitor, there are so many different options for the Garmin R10, which makes it so versatile, along with the cost of $599. Before I move forward, here is the pricing for the Garmin Golf membership. So if you're gonna use Home Tee Hero, it is $99.99 per year, or monthly at $9.99 a month. Next, we'll go into Awesome Golf. Again, I'll go over the pricing at the end. I do own this software. This is the second software that I use. Once I upgraded to a full-size golf simulator, I wanted something that was more, higher resolution graphics and whatnot. So Awesome Golf is a great option if you wanna practice and use that data to learn how to golf better. It is an excellent utility. There are four virtual golf courses. This is not really a software that's intended to be, to ever have a lot of virtual golf courses. You know, I'll go over some of the options for that here in just a minute, but they are working on a few more than the four that they currently have. They say that they'll be available before the end of the year. That's one of the priorities, but it is an excellent, excellent practice utility. So here's some of the options that are available with Awesome Golf. First, for the range, you have shot by shot, approach shots, which have a bunch of different distances that you can hit to, club distances, and then also a coaching mode, which is really nice. Next, we have the shootouts, which is Super Splash, Boat Blast, Wrecking Balls, and Get in the Hole. And those are more games, and those are great for kids too, for learning. Next, we have the challenges. For the challenges, you have closest to the pin, longest drive, target golf, and the skills challenge. Now let's get into the virtual golf options. You have Spring Park Hills, Island Beach, Desert Canyon, and Valley Pines. I have played both the Spring Park Hills and the Valley Pines courses quite a bit. Here are also some of the different screenshots from the practice ranges and then also from the virtual golf. Here is the distance range for Awesome Golf. Next, you have another distance range that have different targets and greens. You have the screenshot of the coaching mode. And then here's a couple of stills from the virtual golf. As far as the cost for Awesome Golf, this week they were having a sale for $299.99 for a lifetime license, which is a great deal. The regular cost is $349.99 or $350, which is what I paid for my perpetual license. All right, our next software is going to be E6, and E6 is going to be another step up graphically. It is an excellent software, and there are different licenses that you can get for E6, and let's go over that. You have an E6 license, just a perpetual license that is good forever, essentially. You have subscriptions, and then you have premium course add-ons. So let's take a look at that. Here's a couple of screenshots from their virtual golf. Again, it is very realistic software. And here's some of the options. Currently, they did have a sale this week for $250 for a yearly subscription for a 27 course library. The normal price is $300. Then they have an expanded subscription, which is on sale this week for $450. Normal price is going to be $600. And that gives you access to online events, peer-to-peer, and all non-premium course content available in E6 Connect throughout the year. Then you have a perpetual license, and that is $2,500, and that gives you 27 courses, the driving range facility, and multiple modes of play. And then you also have premium course add-ons. So like if you wanted to buy Pebble Beach, that is $300 currently. And that is obviously a very, very good course. So I like the subscription idea for E6. I think that makes the most sense because you never know. I mean, as you're moving forward, if you get 2-3 years down the road and you decide to start using another software, at least you're not buried in that $2,500 perpetual license. I'm not saying that's a bad idea. That may be for you, and that's for you to determine. All right, so the next software. This is going to be the Golf Club 2019. Honestly, if there is any software that is out there that I would really like to have, it's this. I'll explain in a little bit here what I'm using. Now, the cost of the Golf Club 2019 is $980 for a perpetual license. And I think that that's a nice value considering all the massive amount of golf courses that are available with the Golf Club 2019 and the realism of the graphics that doesn't really tax a computer as much as maybe another option I'll talk about later, which I've solved. Now, again, like I said, I would love to have this software. I'm currently paying a subscription for $250 a year for another software, which I'll talk about at the end. And then I also have Awesome Golf. They do not have a subscription, which I would prefer, because again, I don't know going forward what I'm gonna do. I've already changed my software 3 times in the 9 months that I've been using a golf simulator. So I would prefer to have a subscription. It is not currently offered. Although I do think that $980 is a very reasonable price for what you're getting for the Golf Club 2019. Here's a couple of screenshots from the virtual golf gameplay. And then let's move on to the newest addition to the Garmin golf app family, and that is Creative Golf. And Creative Golf is kind of on the par, from what I can tell, graphically, to about maybe Awesome Golf's level of graphics, which is more than adequate, I would say. And here's a screenshot of Creative Golf. And this can be a little bit confusing, but let me go over all the different game modes that Creative Golf has. So you've got the golf courses, you've got the driving range, team training, club fitting, chip and putt, practice on course, putting, target golf, easy golf, mini golf, demolition golf, and tournaments. So lots of options there. So there's a lot of different options, and I haven't really dove into this too much, but you've got all these different price levels. So you've got all-in-one for Garmin, which is $1,800, and that's everything. You've got Creative Golf, which is $840. You've got Golfissimo. I don't know what that is. Probably like the Target Golf. That's $600. You got the Course Library, a one-time purchase for $600. You've got All-in-One, so on and so forth. There's 8 different costs here. And they do have an annual subscription for $240 for the Course Library, which I think is more than fair for the software. As far as integrations with Garmin, that's about it. However, the primary software that I use is GS Pro. Now, GS Pro is open API. So there is a program that you can download on GitHub that will allow you to pair your Garmin with your computer so that it will work with GS Pro, and it's free. Now, GS Pro is one of the most realistic softwares out there. You're going to need a gaming computer for it with a decent GPU and RAM, because it's going to use more of your system resources, because there's a lot going on within the software and it is very realistic. I think right now there's over 400 golf courses, and you have a lot of real life golf courses, even maybe local for you, that are available with GS Pro. Like I said, it is not supported by Garmin, however, it will work. So you've got local matches, which is your golfing. You've got practice mode, which is your different practice ranges. You've got tournaments and online matches. Here's a couple screenshots from GS Pro. Here's another shot here. And another shot here. Here are some photographs of my golf simulator with the GS Pro software. As you can tell, it is absolutely stunning and vivid. Again, the cost is $250 per year for your subscription. And they do have another option that's $550 for a lifetime license. However, you're not going to get updates. So if they come out with version 3, version 4, or whatnot, you're not getting that. So in my opinion, you should just stick with the subscription and keep your software updated. So that's going to about do it for the Garmin Approach R10 software options and costs. So if you are interested in the Garmin Approach R10, I'm going to put a link down in the comments to Roxor Golf, who is an affiliate, where if you purchase the Garmin Approach R10 through Roxor Golf, I will receive a small commission for your purchase. Please smash that like button and share with your friends that may be interested in the Garmin Approach R10. I certainly do appreciate you watching today. Please hit that subscribe button and turn on the notifications so that you get notified when I release new content such as this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.